change direction, and I'm looking back toward the north from the south, up to the hill. High Point is over here, and the homes are over in this area here. From here, now we're looking down into what I call the stormwater quality basin that was constructed in part to manage the stormwater runoff caused by the of the homes adjacent to the site. Quite pretty. Oh, here, there we go here. These power lines are not on the county's property. They are just immediately to the east. But this pond is quite an attraction, I believe, and an asset that we should take advantage of as part of the development of the site. Not so great here with that riser, but that can be landscaped away. This is the dam that was constructed to contain the water. Basically, if you don't understand this, when water would get so high, rather than going over the dam, it goes down through the spillway and out into the stream. It's a safety device, meters out the water, improves the water quality from runoff as it goes downstream. Different views. Now, we're going to talk more about what's over here in the next few slides. This would be in the southwesterly part of the property. Farm Bridge Road is right beyond over here. There's a sign, and right over there is a house, the roof of a house down the hill on the Farm Bridge. Here's a continuation of that road, and this path actually goes through to another gate that is locked on the southerly side of the property. Here's a pond. This is the early pond that was used for irrigation. You can see there was a little shed that contained the controls and the electricity for the pumping of the pond. So, and obviously there it is again. There's a dam across here, and the dam sort of becomes very flat. But it is the asset, one of the, aside from the view, I would say this is a great asset for the quality of the property in its future. This is the spillway as it is, or was at the time. Water was flowing over, and the county has already taken some measures to stabilize this on a temporary basis. But this is something long-term that would have to get taken care of in order to maintain the existence of the pond in the first place, because it's getting old, the dam has seen better days, and would have to get repaired. What we were photographing here was the runoff from that pond, and I don't know if we have it in the next slide, Paul. Yeah, this isn't a great photograph because it's very difficult. But what was happening is the water is flowing over the top and undercutting the backside of the dam. But as I said, the county parks has taken some emergency measures immediately following this photograph to stabilize that area for the moment. And this is the gate that one would see from Farm Bridge Road. And this is Farm Bridge Road, decidedly different. I'm going to make a comment about it in a minute, but its width is very, very narrow, not suitable for accepting large volumes or any large. It is not New Cut Road, let's put it that way. It is really a local farm road that should remain as such. And you can see the residences, the quiet residences on the southerly side of the road. What we did is we took some data that we were able to download, GIS information, to begin to say, where are the steep slopes? Are there excessive slopes here that we need to be concerned about? So anything, the lighter the color green, the more gentle the slopes, and the steeper the topography in the brownish and the very spotty red colors are slopes that really we need to stay off from a development point of view, to leave them in the natural state because of the potential for erosion on a long-term basis and difficulty in development. In the blue, you can see the ponds. Note that this one is partly on the county's property, partly on the subdivision. Okay. We also looked at soils. This comes from the federal government, actually. And we used a similar sort of thing in terms of color. The light green and tan color. the browns are less well drained, and in the these narrow thin strips are little beginnings of wetland areas or wetland sensitive areas. That is to say, the groundwater is breaking out, following the topography, flowing into the pond. This one, you can see a little one here behind the houses, just a little drainage channel, poorly drained soils feeding the pond, which is good. This is, as I said, a groundwater fed pond and a little right through here. But this is much more important. This is important because this is truly a wetland that has some potential for improving wildlife habitat quality. It's been disturbed a little bit, but with a little bit of improvement in terms of vegetation management and so on, this could be a very interesting natural area suitable for education and also preservation. So when we take all of that stuff that I just told you about, we sort of combined our thoughts and called it an existing conditions analysis. So let me walk you through it again. Here we are at Nutt. Good point of access, comes up the hill. You know, there's an existing road, a farm road that gets us up to the top of the hill. This other one starting over here where Duke Power has its easement is another path that goes all the way through the site. Those last group of photographs that I showed you were taken along this road, coming down into this pond, this wetland area, really interesting, that was designated by our biologist as a true wetland. You can also begin to see the differences in vegetation up on the top, more open here. We have these pointed views off to the west, views to the south, a little bit of view toward the southeast. So we have some exciting things that we can work with. We're not always presented with some good assets from which to develop. Okay, hold that slide. Let's get off that. Let's come back. We're going to have to shift screens here in a minute. So what we did in the last meeting, we queried everyone who was here and asked, what would you like to have here? And what don't you want to have here? So, and because we came here with an open mind and asked for information, there were some really good sentiments that were expressed. And I'd like to go through these. I'm not going to pass judgment on them because I'm going to stop after this and ask for your thoughts. And then we can proceed from there. It may not be appropriate to proceed. If somebody gets up here and all of you say, forget that, we want active ball fields here. That isn't what we heard last time. If that's the sentiment, then we have something else to talk about. So let's start with you. So we took the comments and from all of the handwritten notes that we had and said, broke them down into broad groups. What is the character and what are the uses? So what we heard is that this is a rural part of Spartanburg County. Anybody disagree? This is very pleasant rural atmosphere that we heard people wanted to maintain. There are single family homes. Most of them are on large parcels. Perhaps the new subdivision is the smallest parcels in the area. And as a somewhat of an outsider, I can offer the compliment, I hope you don't take it as a gratuitous compliment, that the houses are well maintained, the properties are well maintained, and I think that that's a real asset for this part of the county. Historically, it's agricultural, a part of the region of the county, peach orchards, and there's opportunity for rural open space. So let me scroll out a little bit, Paul. All right. So here are the uses that we heard. Blended multiple uses. No one came out and said to us, we want this to be only one thing. People said they wanted to take advantage of the quality of the ponds as an asset. For sure. Maintain and enhance wildlife habitat corridors. That's keeping, in that concept is in keeping with the rural quality. Passive recreation, we heard fishing, we were camping, ropes course, so that gets a little bit more active, trails for hiking, jogging, walking, and picnicking. So that fits into the passive recreation. We heard opportunities for outdoor education in conjunction with the schools. They saw this as an opportunity to bring students from the classroom out to an outdoor environment. Mountain biking, not motorized, but pedal biking. There was some, I think that comment came on just prior to that, I think was the mountain biking festival up here in Canada that attracted a lot of people. So that sentiment, I think, emanated from there. Respect the agricultural heritage. Even somebody threw out a suggestion that we put a peach museum. We've heard that elsewhere in the county, but in any event, respecting the agricultural heritage is the message. Opportunities for scouting. And so that ties to the outdoor education and certainly for the camping as well. Horse trails. We heard the need. There was a woman here who said that, I forget the number, I'm going to make it up, 10,000 horses in Spartanburg County. I don't know if that's a good number or a bad number, but anyway, that was a number. And there was a need for horse trails. There was an expression of a multi-use community building for private and public events, for rental opportunities. In a different setting, this is not the pavilion at Cleveland Park, but something that people could have events of some sort on a for-pay basis. People were concerned about taking advantage of the dark sky. Could we introduce an opportunity for people to put up a telescope and get a clear view of the heavens? Open space area for field sports such as soccer. I want to make the distinction here, not formal. The concept that was expressed was to have an open area for free play, large enough that some groups in the neighborhood or people picnicking could play a little soccer. Use native plant material as part of this. A few tennis courts, not lighted, for nearby adults. And then, obviously, no motorized vehicles. So, I'd like to stop there. We can have the lights, and I'm going to take some notes. So, agree, disagree? Anybody have some thoughts? Now, this is your opportunity to give us input, because we as designers can't go much farther without some confirmation or disagreement on some or all of those, and we're certainly willing to take them. So, sir, you're in the first row, you get the first choice.
Why not baseball? We've been told for 7 years.
Okay.
500-600 kids up here that play ball in District 1, our volleyball. And we were told a long time ago that they got this problem. There was going to be a baseball field up here to play.
I'm not going to disagree with you at all, but that is not something that we've heard previously, and we certainly hear it now.
Who wasn't that me?
I'm sorry about that. That was advertised, but obviously, I have a lot more people. So that's something that we can include in here, and let's see how your